This lecture deals with converting a given NFA to DFA. So as you all know, NFA and DFA are equivalent in terms of power. In the sense, DFA can accept the set of languages that are accepted by or recognized by NFA. So this lecture actually focuses on NFA to DFA conversion process. So consider this particular NFA. You know that these two zero transitions leads to non-determinism. And again, if you consider Q2, it's having two one transitions. That leads to non-determinism. Again, Q2 is not having zero transition. So this is the given NFA and we are trying to design DFA. So let us consider the tabular representation. Here it is Q, here it is sigma. So as you all know, you are having two input symbols, 0 and 1. You have to start from the start state. So if Q0 is the start state in our NFA, Q0 return inside square bracket pair, that is the notation. So if you consider any state in our DFA, that state will be a combination of set of states in our NFA, or the state in our DFA, equivalent DFA, will be a subset of the set of states in our NFA. And that subset will be represented or enclosed within square bracket pair rather than curly braces. So that is actually a notation. So this is the start state. You have to designate using an arrow since it is start state. Now from Q0, what happens for zero transition? From Q0, for zero, it will remain in the same state Q0. And it will go to state Q1. So you are having two options, Q0, Q1. That is, to this state, if you apply 0, it will remain in the same state or it will go to state Q1. So encapsulate it within a square bracket. So while applying input to a particular state, you will get a target state. That state is, or that state contains set of states in our NFA. And if the new state, the target state obtained, does not belong to set of states determined so far, you have to add it to set of states. That is, check whether Q0 or Q1 is there in this set. No. So you can add Q0, Q1. Now apply input 1 to Q0. So if you consider Q0, for one transition, it's going to Q2. There is only one transition. So you are getting Q2. Check whether this particular state belongs to this set of states. No. So you can add Q2 to set of states. Now to this state, apply input 0 and 1. So if you consider this state, it is having Q0 and Q1. So first apply 0 input to Q0. If you apply 0 input to Q0, you will be getting Q0 and Q1. So you will be getting Q0 and Q1. Now to state Q1, apply 0 input. So if we apply 0 input to Q1, you will be getting the state Q0, which is already there in this set. So what you have done is you have taken delta Q00 union delta Q10. So what is delta Q00? Q00 is Q0 Q1, set Q0 Q1. That is, from Q0, if you apply input 0, you can go to Q0 and Q1. Union, what about Q10? Q10 is If you apply 0 transient to Q1, you are going to Q0. So you will be getting Q0. So what happens if you take union? You will be getting Q0, Q1. Then represent inside square bracket. So that is this particular state. Now, by applying an input to a particular state, you will be getting a target state. Check whether this particular state belongs to the current set of states. So this element Q0, Q1 is here. So you don't need to add it to the set of states. It's already there. Now to this state, apply input 1. So how will you trace the target state? That is delta Q01 union delta Q11. So this is equal to, what is delta Q01? To state Q0, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q2. So to state Q0, if you apply input 1, it will go to state Q2. Union. What about delta Q11? To state Q1, if you apply input 1, it will remain in the same state, Q1. So the target set obtained is Q1, Q2. If you take union, you will be getting Q1, Q2. Represent that sequence inside square bracket. So you will be getting Q1, Q2. Check whether this element is currently there in the set of states. No. So this is a new state. So you have to add it to set of states. So you have to repeat this process until you have completed applying all the inputs 0 and 1 exactly once to each and every states in the DFA. Now you are having Q2 here. To state Q2, apply 0. So Q2 0 is null set. Now Q2 1, to this state apply 1. So Q2 1 is actually, if you consider transitions, Q2 1 goes to Q1 and Q0. So you are getting Q0 Q1. Q2 1 goes to Q0 and Q2 1 goes to Q1. So you are getting Q0 Q1. Check whether Q0 Q1 is already there in this set of states. Q0 Q1 is here. Now to state Q1 Q2, apply 0. So how will you trace the target state? Delta Q1 0 union delta Q2 0. So this is equal to, what about delta Q1 0? Q1 0 goes to Q0. So Q0 union. What about Q2 0? Q2 is not having 0 transition, null set. So you are getting Q0. That will be the target state. While applying input to a particular state, after getting the target state, you have to check whether that state is there in the set of states. Since Q0 is there in this set, you don't need to add Q0 explicitly because this state is already here. Now to this state, apply input 1. How will you apply input 1? Delta Q11 union delta Q21. Now what about delta Q11? Delta Q11 is, to state Q1, if you apply 1, you will be remaining in the same state Q1. Union. What about Q21? If you consider Q21, Q21 goes to Q0 and Q1. So it goes to Q0 and Q1. Q21 goes to Q0 and Q1. So if you take union, you will be getting Q0, Q1. So represent inside the square bracket, you will be getting the target state. That will be the target state. So add it here, Q0, Q1. Now, at this point, this process stops because you can see that you have applied all the input 0 and 1 exactly once to each and every states in our DFA. In this way you have to pull out or trace all states in our DFA. Now let me construct or represent this using equivalent transition diagram. These are actually labels. So if you want, you can relabel this as a new state Q0, this is Q1, this is Q2, this is Q3. So that relabeling can be also done. So we are constructing without any relabeling. So from here, it is pretty clear that Q0 is the start state. The remaining states include Q0, Q1. Remember that these are actually state labels. You are having Q2, then you are having Q1, Q2. Now how will you identify the final states? So these are the states in our equivalent DFA, and Q2 is the final state in our NFA. So those sequence containing Q2 as a member can be fixed as final state. So here Q2 is not there, here Q2 is not there, here Q2 is there. So this will be a final state. Here also Q2 is there, so this will be a final state. So mark this as final state and this as final state. And again, if you consider this transition table, there exists a null set here. So that is also a target state. So null set actually represent dead state or trap state. Now you can add transitions. From Q0, if you apply input 0, it will go to Q0, Q1. So it will go to Q0, Q1. From Q0, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q2. Now from Q0, Q1, if you apply input 0, it will remain in the same state. Now from Q0, Q1, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q1, Q2. If you apply input 1, it will go to Q1, Q2. Now from Q2, if you apply input 0, it will go to trap state. Now from Q2, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q0, Q1. From this state, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q0, Q1. Now from Q1, Q2, if you apply input 0, it will go to Q0. Now from Q1, Q2, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q0, Q1. So from here, if you apply input 1, it will go to Q0, Q1. So we can avoid this overlapping from Q0 over input 1, it will go to Q2. Now, if you consider this transition diagram, each and every state is having exactly one 0 transition and one transition. Here also 0 transition, 1 transition. If you consider here 1 transition, 0 transition. If you consider here 0 transition, 1 transition. But what about trap state? So for trap state or dead state, so this is called as trap state or dead state. Both transitions will remain in the same state. 0 and 1 transitions will remain in the same state. Now this transition diagram actually satisfies the properties of DFA. In the sense, this is the DFA equivalent to this particular NFA. And if you verify a string, if you take any string that is recognized by this model, that will be also accepted by this model. If you take any string rejected by this one, that will be also rejected by this one. So let us take an example. Let us consider the string 001. That is 001. Check whether this machine accepts it or not. 001. That get accepted. Now consider another string. So this is an accepted string. Another string 0000. Okay, you can consider 0001 that get rejected. Check whether this model reject it or not. So this is a string that get rejected by NFA. 0011 that get rejected. If we apply 0011, this machine will end up at this particular state, which is a non-final state, indicating that string is set to be rejected. So our conclusion is that if you take any NFA, you can convert it into equivalent DFA. In the sense, you can eliminate non-determinism from that finite automata to obtain a deterministic model. So question is, why NFA? If you are asked to design a finite automata that solves a particular problem, it is easier to design non-deterministic finite automata as compared to a deterministic model. So in order to solve that problem, first just easily design NFA. Once after designing NFA, there exists a systematic procedure that converts that NFA to DFA. So once after designing NFA, just convert it into equivalent DFA, and you can directly or you can write a program that converts a given NFA to equivalent DFA. Then your task become little bit easier. You need to design NFA only, feed that NFA as input to the program in the form of a transition table. Your program will convert the input NFA to equivalent DFA. That's it.